Sir, you forgot to open your mic.
The local anesthetic, lidocaine and norepinephrine combined, yeah? So why we use this norepinephrine in combination with local anesthesia? So when you put your needle, inject the drug here, yeah? So in subcutaneous tissue, we are also having blood vessels, yeah? Understand? In subcutaneous tissue, we are also having blood vessel. Blood vessel having alpha 1 receptor. Done. So if you inject inside the skin, this norepinephrine causing what? Vasoconstriction. Then drug not enter to blood is very also very safe. One thing. Drug not move here and there. Clear? So norepinephrine we use in combination with local anesthetic to increase the duration of action. Then that local anesthetic can act for longer duration. Because local anesthetic, for example, the drug we inject here, so green dots and norepinephrine, the blue dot is the real drug, local anesthetic, yeah? So when you apply this drug mixture together, local anesthetic, lidocaine and norepinephrine in combination, yeah? Combined together. So norepinephrine causing vasoconstriction. So vasoconstriction, now what happened here? This drug is not move here and there in blood vessel, not enter to blood. It's also safe. Because if this local anesthetic enter to blood, it can cause cardiac arrest. Because these are sodium blocker. These are sodium blocker. Ventricle having receptor, sodium channel, you know, depolarization done by sodium channel ventricle muscle. Understand? Also safe. So local anesthetic, the duration of action also increase. Duration of action also increase. Clear? For longer duration, this drug stay here. It causing anesthetic effect. It block the nerve. Understand? So we use mixture of lidocaine, local anesthetic, sodium blocker in combination with norepinephrine. It's a third use. Done? The concept about norepinephrine clear?
Sir.
Norepinephrine causing blood pressure high. Which blood pressure high? 120 by 80. Which blood pressure more high with norepinephrine? Let me know. Diastolic or systolic? There are two pressure. This one systolic. This one diastolic. Okay, listen here.
Yeah.
This 120 depend upon heart contraction, okay?
Yes, sir.
Upper one depend upon heart contraction. Lower one depend upon the resistance. Clear? So when you use norepinephrine increase resistance, increase this blood pressure to 90 to 100. Understand? Norepinephrine increase diastolic blood pressure. Especially diastolic blood pressure. Clear? Norepinephrine increase diastolic blood pressure. It also has little influence on systolic also. Okay. Epinephrine directly systolic blood pressure high. Diastolic may be little decrease like this. It's norepinephrine. This norepinephrine done?
Yes, sir.
These all drugs belong to alpha receptor. Alpha 1 drug done. Alpha 2 drug done. Yeah? And combined drug for alpha 1 and alpha 2 also done. Norepinephrine. Three drugs done. Okay, now come to move on. Beta receptor. Okay? Beta 1. And beta 1 and beta 2. If drug act on beta 1 and beta 2 same time, it's a non-selective beta agonist not epinephrine. So epinephrine here, sorry. Epinephrine, clear? Epinephrine prefer beta 1, beta 2, beta receptor first. Drug directly go to beta 1. Only beta 1. Dobutamine. Dobutamine. Drug only go to beta 1. Isoproterenol. 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 Okay. These two drugs. Dobutamine only for beta 1. For beta 1 and beta 2, epinephrine. So which one selective? It's a non-selective. It's a non-selective. Non-selective beta agonist. How about dobutamine and isoproterenol? These are selective. Selective beta agonist. They go for beta 1 and one go for beta 2. How about the beta 2? Beta 2 having two groups. Short action. Long action. For short action. Terbutaline. Terbutaline. L-butyrol. L-butyrol. Clear? Terbutaline, L-butyrol, sal, L-butyrol, another. L-butyrol, terbutaline, salbutamol. 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 These three are short acting, okay? So short acting, done. Long action. Form metirol, sal metirol, sal metirol, form metirol, clear? Sal metirol and form metirol. These are long action, long acting drug. Clear, clear? Long action and short action. Okay, these are the also selective beta 2. Selective beta 2. Selective beta 1. Non-selective beta. Clear or not? Okay, selective and non-selective. First, we finish this beta 2 easily. Beta 2 we use for what? Beta 2 agonist we use for asthma. Beta 2 we use for COPD. Patient having difficulty in breathing, okay? These drugs mostly available in inhaler form, inhale form. Market inhaler available. Okay? Use for asthma. Okay, if patient having asthma attack, you need quick relief. Which drug you prefer? Long action, short action?
Short.
Must be short, okay? Must.
Yeah.
Okay, if patient having, sometimes student make a mistake here. If patient having like asthma attack, yeah? That time patient feeling difficulty in breathing. So that time we need quick relief. For quick relief, must use short acting. Terbutaline, salbutamol, L-butyrol. Clear? Terbutaline, salbutamol, L-butyrol. Done? Understand?
Yes, sir.
For quick relief, this short action we use for quick relief. Clear? How about the long action? Long acting. This long acting for maintenance of therapy. for long action in combination with short action if patient presented in emergency having difficulty in breathing. Yeah, so that time we not use long action. Long action take time for to perform its action. It take a lot of time to start action on beta 2. Clear? So we must use short action for quick relief, for long acting for proper therapy of asthma. Okay, for proper maintenance of bronchodilation. Beta 2 receptor causing what? Beta 2 receptor was present on smooth muscle of respiratory system. It causing bronchodilation. Bronchodilation. Now, tell me one thing here. If you inhale the drug, can this drug go in your body very high concentration? If you just inhale, it directly go to lungs, yeah?
Yeah.
So it's not causing much decreased blood pressure. So beta 2 also causing vasodilation. Beta 2 also causing vasodilation, okay? So it's not decrease. These drug, because you just inhale, yeah? These drug not going to body to in high concentration. These drug just go to respiratory system. They have not much effect on your blood pressure, understand? If little concentration, beta 2 agonist, enter to blood, what happened with blood glucose? Let me know. What happened with
increase?
How beta 2 receptor on alpha cell increase glucagon, understand? So when you're using this inhaler can cause hyperglycemia, understand? So this is not much a bigger problem. Why? Because you just inhale the drug. This drug is not enter your blood in very high concentration, very little concentration enter to blood. It's not causing very high hyperglycemia, understand? So beta 2 drug, these drug can interfere with diabetes a little. Done? So they can increase blood sugar level. Solmeterol, formeterol, long-term control of asthma, okay? For quick relief, terbutaline, albuterol, salbutamol. These are short acting for quick relief, okay? Okay, now come to beta 1 selective. The butamine and isoproterenol. These two drugs just act on if patient in cardiac arrest. What is the location of beta 1? On heart, on renin releasing cell, in eye, okay? So beta 1, dobutamine, if the person having cardiogenic shock, dobutamine we use for cardiogenic shock. Understand? If patient suddenly heart stop working, that time we can give dobutamine. So prefer dobutamine because the isoproterenol also go for beta 2 sometimes. But the butamine only prefer beta 1 specially. Clear? Beta 1 specially. So for cardiac arrest purpose, we can use these two drugs. The butamine, isoproterenol for cardiac arrest. Understand? Okay, now come to beta 1 and beta 2 combine action. Which drug non-select? It's epinephrine now. Epinephrine. What are the uses of epinephrine? There are many uses of epinephrine. Norepinephrine not have much uses, but epinephrine many uses. Epinephrine, if patient blood pressure low, use epinephrine. Okay. Patient having cardiac arrest. Use epinephrine. Because epinephrine prefer which receptor? Beta receptor, both beta receptor. Yeah. Cardiac arrest, we need this beta action. Yeah. Heart sudden stop working. For cardiac, this is a drug of choice for cardiac arrest, epinephrine. If you not have epinephrine, give atropine. You know, these two drugs always available in emergency. Epinephrine and atropine. Okay. These two drugs are emergency drug for cardiac arrest. Must keep in mind. Clear? Okay. Third one, third drug for cardiac arrest, dobutamine. For cardiac arrest, we now having three drugs available in emergency. Number one, dobutamine. Number two, epinephrine. Which one preferable? First, epinephrine. Very strong for beta action. Okay. Epinephrine, dobutamine, and we also have another option, atropine. So these three drugs we use for cardiac arrest patient. If patient having like heart attack and sudden heart stop working, the last hope here. We give injectable, then we defibrillate the heart. This, you know, give electric shock. Yeah. After injecting these drugs, then we give electric shock, maybe hope for life. Understand? For cardiac arrest, epinephrine for cardiac arrest, atropine for dobutamine. These three drugs must keep in mind, okay, for cardiac arrest. Decrease blood pressure, we can use epinephrine. For cardiac arrest, we can use epinephrine. For shock, for which category of shock? There are two shock. Number one, patient having cardiogenic shock. Which shock? Shock due to heart pathology, cardiogenic shock. If patient having anaphylactic shock. Anaphylactic shock. I ask one question here. Why you prefer epinephrine for anaphylactic shock? Why you not go for norepinephrine for anaphylactic shock? Anaphylactic shock. What is the action of norepinephrine? Norepinephrine only go for alpha receptors, you know. Norepinephrine only can handle blood pressure just. In anaphylactic shock, there are two problems. Anaphylactic shock. Histamine causing anaphylactic shock due to sometime patient having reaction, yeah? Hypersensory reaction, anaphylaxis, some drugs maybe, some toxin maybe. Causing vasodilation. Histamine enter to respiratory system and causing bronchoconstriction. Histamine causing bronchoconstriction, patient also having dyspnea, difficulty in breathing, anaphylactic shock, blood pressure also low, and patient having breathing difficulty. Understand? So breathing difficulty and blood pressure, the two problem here. So if you only use norepinephrine, norepinephrine can solve blood pressure problem. Understand? Clear or not? Can you improve breathing with norepinephrine? Why not?
No, sir.
Because no action on beta. Norepinephrine have action on beta?
Alpha.
No action. Okay, now come on epinephrine. Epinephrine have beta 1 action. What is the equation for blood pressure? Blood pressure equal to cardiac output multiplied by resistance. Cardiac output having two parts, heart rate and stroke volume. Understand? So epinephrine doing what? Epinephrine, heart rate increased by beta 1. You increasing heart rate. If you increase heart rate, cardiac output increase. Oh, it means blood pressure increase, yeah? So epinephrine also can increase blood pressure. No problem. Now come to beta 2. Patient having breathing difficulty. Patient having, also having breathing difficulty. So why? Because histamine doing what? Broncho constriction. So now what happened? Dyspnea. Dyspnea means breathing difficulty. Dyspnea. Okay. Epinephrine causing what? Bronchodilation. Understand? So this bronchoconstriction change to bronchodilation. Now, epinephrine also two problem in anaphylactic shock. Number one, decrease blood pressure. You can increase blood pressure by epinephrine. You also can solve this problem by epinephrine because beta 2 action. That's why for anaphylactic shock. Anaphylactic shock also vasodilatory shock, okay? But the problem here, the patient along with decreased blood pressure also have issue with breathing difficulty there. So you can increase blood pressure and increase and improve breathing difficulty, okay? No more breathing difficulty with the epinephrine. Epinephrine help in both cases, okay? Norepinephrine only can improve blood pressure, not improve dyspnea. Because no beta. Now you understand why norepinephrine not preferable for anaphylactic shock.
Clear?
This another benefit. This epinephrine block the release of histamine. Oh, another benefit. In anaphylaxis, lot of histamine there. Yeah, epinephrine also block histamine release. So it's a best drug. If patient having lot of sting bite, bee sting, honey bee, if someone disturb them, then you know what happened, yeah? Lot of honey bees, bee sting there, bee sting on full body, what happened? Bee sting, the toxin causing vasodilation. Which drug you give to patient? Bee sting, listen here, bee sting, when the bee sting there, release histamine, okay? Lot of histamine in body. So lot of histamine in body, the bee sting, lot of bee sting there, clear? Honey bee sting. The bee sting causing histamine release, histamine causing decreased blood pressure, histamine causing bronchoconstriction, okay? Another person come in emergency, have history of intake of penicillin. Penicillin causing hypersensitivity, also causing histamine release. Understand? Yeah. If patient have like, they have any drug reaction there, so it release histamine. So at that time, if any patient come with anaphylaxis or anaphylactic shock, okay, you must give epinephrine, your drug of choice, epinephrine. Understand the uses of epinephrine done? Epinephrine used for simple decrease in blood pressure. Epinephrine used for cardiac arrest. Epinephrine used for shock patient. Which shock? Cardiogenic shock also. Anaphylactic shock also. Okay. Epinephrine we also can use for simple. Number fourth use, patient not having decreased blood pressure, only having anaphylaxis. And anaphylaxis. It means allergic reaction. Okay. Anaphylaxis. Number fifth, using beta 2 agonist. Come here. Beta 2 agonist, short action and long action, done for use for asthma. Yeah. Patient have very severe asthma attack. Asthma attack just stay for 1, 2, or 3 minutes, maximum 5 minutes. If the asthma attack stay for 15 to 30 minutes, patient not able to take inhaler because if not able to breathe, how can take inhaler? It's very hard for patient, yeah? Patient not improving by using these drugs, quick relief, no more quick relief there. And what you give to patient? That condition, if asthma attack persists for longer duration, 15 to 30 minute asthma attack, is known as status asthmaticus. Status asthmatic. What is status asthmaticus? Asthma attack persists for 15 to 30 minutes. No quick relief with the by using inhaler, by using short action. Clear? Short acting alpha beta 2 agonist. Albuterol, salbutamol, terbutaline. Clear? Terbutaline, salbutamol, albuterol. So these drugs, patient not improving well, yeah? So now we can give patient not improving with other beta 2. The other drug for beta receptor, we know have epinephrine, yeah? Give IV epinephrine, must keep in mind, okay? For status asthmaticus, using IV intravenous. Intravenous epinephrine. For status asthmaticus. So also very important use here. Here also again, life-saving for asthma patients. Asthma attack is not relieved by short-acting and long-acting beta-2 agonist, okay? Like solmeterol, formeterol, albuterol, salbutaline, terbutaline, clear? So these drugs are not effective, is not relieving the asthma attack. Now patient now severe dyspnea, hypoxia, patient undergoing faint condition now because very low oxygen inside, yeah? At that time, the hope for life here, epinephrine. If patient have status asthmaticus, very severe asthma attack, okay? That time we can use epinephrine IV, intravenous. Uses of epinephrine done?
Sir.
Epinephrine uses. Decrease blood pressure. Cardiac arrest, cardiogenic shock, anaphylactic shock, anaphylaxis, status asthmaticus, okay? Status asthmaticus. In anaphylaxis, you can add bee sting, drug allergy, any drug allergy, okay? Epinephrine, say anaphylaxis, allergic reaction, okay? These are the uses of epinephrine. Uses of epinephrine. Just now we finished direct acting. Direct acting part alpha 1, direct acting part alpha 2, direct acting part beta 1, direct acting part beta 2. Clear? Direct acting for beta 1, alpha 1, and beta 2. Okay, last drug, then we finish the remaining, we continue in next class. Alpha 1 done, alpha 2 done, beta 1 done, beta 2 done, okay? For both, here, norepinephrine. For both, here, epinephrine. This you know. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Last one, dopamine. Can you tell me another type of shock, septic shock done, anaphylactic shock done, neurogenic shock done, cardiogenic shock done, four types done, and last one. Tell me last one, last shock.
Hypovolemic.
Hypovolemic. Hypovolemia, why? Patient having dehydration. Yeah, how dehydration, vomiting, diarrhea, clear? Another cause, accident, trauma, in trauma direct blood loss, okay? So if the direct blood loss is known as hemorrhagic shock, okay? Which shock? Hemorrhagic shock. All these shock under category of hypovolemic shock. In hypovolemic shock, when the blood volume, plasma volume decrease, yeah, what happened with blood pressure? Decrease. Body sympathetic system excite. Sympathetic system release what? Norepinephrine. Norepinephrine causing what? Alpha 1 vasoconstriction,
okay.
Try to increase blood pressure. Clear? Try to increase blood pressure. But what happened with kidney? What happened with GIT? What happened with skin? Longer vasoconstriction causing necrosis of skin, necrosis of GIT, necrosis of kidney. Kidney fail in hypovolemic shock. Clear? if you give norepinephrine to hypovolemic shock patient, patient already very strong alpha 1 action, okay, you're going to kill the patient. In hypovolemic shock, never use norepinephrine, must keep in mind. In hypovolemic shock, we also need more volume. We need to save kidney. It's a very important thing here, okay? In hypovolemic shock, we need to save kidney, not only focus to increase blood pressure, also focus to save organs. In hypovolemic shock, we must save GIT. We must save the important thing here, kidney. In hypovolemic shock, the patient died due to renal failure, acute renal failure. Clear? Understood or not? Okay. So if already naturally norepinephrine very high because patient having low blood pressure, sympathetic system excited, more norepinephrine. So if you give more norepinephrine from outside, what happened? More vasoconstriction. Yeah. Can you give blood to kidney now? Alpha 1 receptor strong vasoconstriction, no filtration, GFR, kidney, ischemic necrosis start. The GIT, ischemic necrosis start. Understand? So kidney totally fail if you give norepinephrine. So can you go for epinephrine? Still not a good option. But better than norepinephrine. Epinephrine still not a good option, but better than norepinephrine. Norepinephrine also have one part beta 2 causing vasodilation. So it can save kidney but not increase blood pressure too much because no volume there. We have best drug. We have best drug dopamine. For hypovolemic shock, start dopamine. Dopamine, another name, phenoldopam. It's also dopamine. Phenoldopam. It's also dope. These two drugs, okay? Dopamine directly and phenoldopam. Phenoldopam, dopamine, these two drugs causing what? They have their own receptor. D1, D2. First they go for dopamine, then they go for alpha, then also go for beta 2. Clear? So these two drugs, this dopamine, also go for beta 1. First, act on dopamine receptor, then go for alpha, also go for beta, yeah? So dopamine also increase heart rate, one thing, because also go for beta 1 receptor. Dopamine increasing blood pressure also, dopamine increase kidney flow. This dopamine receptor, D1 and D2 causing vasodilation of renal vessels. Dopamine receptor present on kidney vessel, okay? So dopamine also save your kidney and increase your blood pressure. Here not just focus on increasing blood pressure, okay? You have to save the kidney in hypovolemic shock. Give a lot of fluid and also give dopamine, okay? Not give norepinephrine. If the three option there, dopamine, norepinephrine and epinephrine, which drug first you prefer? Dopamine. Otherwise, you can go for epinephrine, but never go for norepinephrine. Understand? So, in hypovolemic shock, if you use norepinephrine causing vasoconstriction, already very high vasoconstriction, clear? In abdominal organs, all the blood is, when you have blood loss, when you have dehydration, all the total blood is diverted to heart to save the heart and brain. The abdominal organ sacrifice their blood. Clear? The vasoconstriction in GIT, vasoconstriction in renal vessel, all the blood is diverted to brain and heart because brain and heart are vital organs. To save the vital organs, all the blood is moving toward brain and heart. The strong vasoconstriction inside the abdomen. Done? So in hypovolemic shock, never go for norepinephrine because norepinephrine increase vasoconstriction for more longer duration. It will lead to renal failure. Understand? Dopamine for hypovolemic shock. Patient having history of dehydration and vomiting. Now blood pressure very low. Yeah? Blood pressure very low. At that, now patient in shock stage now. Not go for epinephrine, not go for norepinephrine, but just use dopamine. Just use dopamine. For hypovolemic shock, drug of choice, dopamine. For hypovolemic shock, drug of choice, dopamine. Dopamine increase also save your kidney, increasing blood flow to kidney. At the same time, also increasing blood pressure. Understand?
Yes.
Dopamine,
yes, sir.
Also save your kidney. It's a very, very important thing. Must keep in mind. Phenoldopam and dopamine. It's all about today lecture, okay? Only two or three drugs left of the system. Tomorrow we will finish and inshallah start adrenergic antagonist tomorrow also, okay?
Yes, sir.
Must try to correlate this because today lecture is very, these drugs are very important for emergency use. Shock patient, cardiac arrest patient, anaphylaxis patient. Yeah, this is an emergency. Asthma emergency, blood pressure emergency. Clear? So must try to revise this lecture again and again. If you have any question, later can ask. Okay, Allah Hafiz. Assalamu alaikum.
Thank you, sir. Wa alaikum salam.
Welcome.
Wa alaikum salam.